Welcome to Python series for beginners by NetSet OS. In this video, we will discuss about break and continue statements in loops. Sometimes we wish to come out of the loop without checking test expression or before completing the loop, and we want to execute the next statement. Then this break and continue statement come into existence. Break and continue are very important for handling the loop controls. So let's start with break statement. Here, the syntax is very simple. Just you need to write break in Python. Now here, if we come to working of break statement, if you have written this break statement, what Python interpreter will do? It will execute break and you will directly come out of the loop. If it is for loop, then it will come out of the for loop. And this is the body of the loop. So here it will execute the outside the for loop directly. When we talk about while statement, and here we have given the break statement. So it will execute this break and Python interpreter will come out of this while loop. So let's understand this with some examples. So first statement we have given for break here. Here we have given for I in range. Range is always used for continuous numbers like 0 to 5. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 4. Just till 4, because 5 will be not, it's a stop element, it will not get executed. So it will run for 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 times. Now it will ask for, first we will start with I is equal to 0 first. So here it will come, it asks for if I is equal to 4. No, it is not 4. So it will print I. So here it will print 0. Then it will go for I is equal to 1. It asks if I is equal to 4. No, it is not. So it will again print. Then it will go for second. Then it again asks, is it equal to 4? No. Then it will print 2 also. Then it comes to 3. 3 is also not equal to 4. Then it will print 3. Now it comes to 4. Then it asks, I is equal to 4. Yes, 4 is equal to 4. So it will break and come outside of our loop. So it will execute 0, 1, 2, 3, and then outside of for loop. Let's see. I should write this also. So we will run this code. And here we got 0, 1, 2, 3, and outside of for loop. Let's see for other example. Now here we have string over here for value in string. So it will execute for s, t, r, I, n, g. Then value will come to first s and it will ask whether it is I. So we will say no. So it will not go here. It will directly print s. So first it will print s. Then it will go to t. Whether t is equal to I, it will say no. Then it will print again t. Then this loop will go to r. So it will ask whether r is equal to I. No. So it will print value. So it will print r. Now our I will come to I value. Then it will ask for whether I is equal to I. It says yes. So it will break here and come outside the loop. Let's see. C. Here it has ran for S, T, R, and then it will come outside the loop and print the AND. Now we will go to another break in while loop. Let's see in while loop also. So here our I is equal to 0. So it will ask whether 0 is less than or equal to 4. Yes, it is less than 4. So here it will come and I will become 1. So it will ask here whether 1 is equal to 4. No, then it will print 1. So it will print 1 here. Then it will go to while 1 is smaller than 4. Yes. So it will increment this I to 2. And then it will ask whether 2 is equal to 4. No, it is not. Then it will say print I. So we will print 2. Then again it will go and it will ask whether 2 is less than 4. No. I mean to say yes, 2 is less than 4. So it will increment this and I will become 3. So 3 is 3 is equal to 4. No. So it will say print 3. So we will print 3. Then again it will go. 3 is less than 4. Yes. So again it will increment. And this time it will ask whether 4 is equal to 4. Yes, it is. So here this break statement will get executed. And here it will come outside the loop and it will print the end. So let's execute this also. Here first is 1, 2, 3, the end. So this is how break statements work. Let's delete this and now we will see how continue statement works. So for continue, we have simple syntax as break. We will just write continue over here. And when we see the working of continue, here continue takes to the next iteration. As we write here continue statement, the Python interpret execute this and it will take you outside the iteration. Whether if you talk like we talk about break statement, it will take outside the loop. While continue will take you to the next iteration. It will not execute, that is after the continue statement. Now here if we talk about while statement, it will come outside the iteration. So let's understand this by some example. We'll go to PyCharm, clean this, and here in break only, if I write here continue, let's see how it will work. So as you can see here, let's run the with iteration. So here it will run for 0, 1, 2, 3 and 4. So first of all, it will ask for I whether 0 is equal to 4. It will say no. Then it will print 0. So it has printed 0. Then I will increment here. And here it will ask whether 1 is equal to 4. It will say no. So again it will print. So here it has printed 1. Then I will increment here and it will say whether 2 is equal to 4. It will say no, print I. So here it has printed 2 also. Then coming to 3, it will ask 3 is equal to 4. No. So again it will print 3. Then when it comes to 4, it will ask 4 is equal to 4. Yes. So here it will come to continue and again it will come out of the iteration. Then it will ask for 5. This is the end. So here it will go to the else part, then into the else block, and then it will print the outside of for loop. While if we talk about break statement, it has came outside the for else loop. It won't be executing this ran into else block. So let's understand this more deeply by one more example. Here, instead of break, I will write continue. See, here also it has came for ran outside the loop and it has executed ng as well. While in break, it has came outside the loop after I only. Let's see its execution also. Or we will see the. Now, if we come to string, string. Now, value will ask whether s is equal to I. No. So it will print value. Then t is equal to I. No. Then print value. So it will print t. Then r, it is not equal to I. Print r. Then it will come to I. I is equal to I. Yes. So this will execute and it will go again to the n here. Then it will ask n is equal to I. No. Then it will print n. That means if I is not getting executed, it will go to the next iteration. Instead, if we see in break, it has came out of the for or while loop, whatever loop we are executing. So here n is getting executed. Then g will execute here because g is not equal to I and it will print g. And then it will print ran outside of the loop and then it will print the end. So here we have seen for statement. Now we will see for while statement as well. Now we will change this break to continue. And let's see how it works. So here for it executed continue and then again it went to 5 and here it has printed for came out of while loop and the end. So let's see how it works. Now for I is equal to 0, it will come here, it will ask 0 is less than 4. Yes, so it will increment I and here it will check in if condition whether 1 is equal to 4. No. So it will print 1 here. Then it will go to 1 while loop and it will ask 1 is less than 4. Yes. So it will come inside the while body and here it will increment I to 2. And then it will check in if whether 2 is equal to 4. No. So again it will print 2 here. Then here it will go to 2. 2 is less than 4. While will say yes. So it will come to increment here and I becomes 3. Then it will ask if in if condition whether 3 is equal to 4. No. So it will again print 3 here. Then it will go to 3 whether 3 is less than 4. Yes. So it will increment I to 4. Now it will ask whether 4 is equal to 4. Yes. So it will come inside the if body and it will continue and it will go again to while and it will ask whether 4 is equal to 4. Yes. So again it will go and come inside the while body and here it will increment 4 to 5 and if it is here it will ask an if whether 5 is equal to 4. No. Then it will print 5 And here it will come into else body, came out of while loop, and then it will print the end, as it is done here. So if we come to break, break statement, it has came to break here, then it won't be executed again. It will come outside the while else body and directly will print the end. So this is the major difference between break and continue. So break and continue are extremely important in our loop control.
Thanks for watching.
Drop a like.
Leave a comment.
And don't forget to
subscribe.